Okay, let's start. Can you hear me? Okay, my name is Beyhan. It's a pleasure for me to be here today. Thanks for coming. I will talk today about ways to monitor the BOSH directory. And why actually I want to talk about this topic. I am a member of the BOSH Team Europe at SAP, and we contribute to the BOSH core projects. And also we are owning the BOSH OpenStack CPI. Additionally, we operate most of the directors at SAP, the BOSH directors, so we provide BOSH as a service inside SAP to other teams. How many of you operate BOSH in production? Oh, okay, quite a number. Yeah, most probably you know why you need monitoring for BOSH. So today I will talk about why you need monitoring. Afterwards, explain where you can find monitoring data for BOSH and how we monitor the BOSH directory at SAP. Additionally, I will explain how our monitoring and logging stacks looks like and what kind of alerts we have. So the first, most probably, so I don't need to tell you how important automation is, and most probably your automation depends on your BOSH directory. At least at SAP, we have automation which depends on our BOSH directories. All the updates and hot fixes, security patches, changes, they go automatically through pipelines and are propagated from landscape to landscapes. And here you need the BOSH directory to deploy the those changes. Another thing is resurrection. Resurrection is when one VM deployed by BOSH is not running, BOSH will try to repair the VM. This works most of the time under the cover, and it's really nice when it works, but of course you need a working BOSH directory for this. And resurrection can prevent outages, customer impacts in your production systems. Another point are metrics. Actually, the directory is a source for metrics, important metrics for your operation systems. And it's nice to have them and visualize them somewhere. We will talk later what kind of metrics. The last point is actually the most important for us at SAP. We use the BOSH directory to provision services, Cloud Foundry services. So a Cloud Foundry user on our cloud platform, when he types CF create service, maybe the service is provisioned by BOSH. So we do not provision all the services by BOSH, but some of them are provisioned by BOSH. And this is, of course, the direct customer facing operation and puts much more pressure on how BOSH is available, so increases the requirements a lot. That's why monitoring is a very important topic for us. So before we look into how to monitor the BOSH, let's have a short overview of BOSH to better understand how, from where you get the data actually. So the director can provision VMs on supported infrastructures, and this is done through the CPI. For every supported infrastructure, you have a CPI implementation, for example, Azure, AWS, or OpenStack, and so on. There is a well-defined interface between the directory and the CPI, and all the CPIs implement this interface. On the VMs which are provisioned on the infrastructure, there is always one agent, And the agent is responsible to install the software which you want to run on the VM, and also to monitor the software. And the software, the bits agent gets from the blob store, the bits to install. And of course, the director puts the bits there. When you do BOSH port release, then director will port your release into the blob store. Also, the agent reports the state of the processes over the message bus, NUTS, and also some metrics. And here comes the health monitor, which is listening on the agent reports and the metrics. And if something is not as expected, the health monitor will generate an alert, which will be on which the director will react and try to repair the situation. For example, VM is not in running state. Health monitor will get this report from the agent and will generate an alert, and the director will try to repair the situation. This is how redirection works, actually. And the director also use NUTS to send some actions to agents. And at the end, we have the director database where the state of the director is stored. So this is the short overview. And let's have a look where you can find data sources for monitoring BOSH. First, talk about metrics. We saw that agents are sending metrics via the message bus to BOSH, and the metrics which agents sent are about CPU load, memory usage, and disk usage. Of course, you are asking yourself, but wait a minute, we want to actually monitor the BOSH director. And here we get metrics for all the VMs which are created by BOSH by the BOSH director. Right? If you have this setup, you don't have any metrics for the BOSH director itself. That's why at SAP we have the following setup. We deploy our BOSH as a service through another BOSH, which we call the outer BOSH. And in this way, we are able to get we are able to get metrics for the BOSH VM itself. Additionally, we have here redirection, which is nice to have. And if the inner BOSH is not running, the outer BOSH will recreate the VM. And you can use the health monitor to forward those metrics to your monitoring stack. For example, this is a dashboard which we have built based on agent metrics, disk usage in percentage. Through the agent, you get information about the ephemeral, persistent, and system disk. And here you can see that the persistent disk usage was over 80%, which actually triggers an alert on our side. And as you can see on the dashboard, we took an action and the usage went down. So to say, we increased the persistent disk of the BOSH director itself. The agent metrics are a good source to plan the capacity for your BOSH director. For example, the size of the persistent disk, but also if we look into the next dashboard where you can see the CPU load, based on those metrics, you can plan the how big the BOSH director VM should be actually. And yeah, we use those metrics to scale the director up when it's needed. Yeah. Another source of metrics on the BOSH director VM is the Nginx itself. The director is a Ruby rack application, and in front of the director there is an Nginx as reverse proxy. And all the action which you execute with the BOSH CLR are facing the agent, the Nginx on the Bosch directory. And Nginx itself has a feature to provide metrics for itself. And you can enable this feature. By default, it's disabled. With the recent version of Bosch directory, you can enable this feature. And the metrics endpoint will be exposed locally on the Nginx port. If you want to collect those metrics, you have to forward them to your monitoring system. They're only exposed locally. This is very helpful if your Bosch users experience somehow of slow Bosch or many failing requests. Then you can use those metrics to analyze what's going on. Is the Nginx the issue or the directory app behind the Nginx? It's a nice source for user-facing issues. Another source of metric is the local blob store. The local blob store is an Nginx talking the WebDAV protocol. Here in the same way, you can enable the metrics for the blob store itself. And if you face issues with Bosch support release or issues with Bosch DNS, because Bosch DNS is using also the blob store, you can those metrics can be helpful for you. In case of an external blob store, most probably the blob store provider can provide you metrics. We have a setup with a local blob store, and that's why we use this way to get metrics. Another source of metrics is the NATS, the message bus. It has also the feature to provide you with metrics. Again, it's by default disabled, but with the recent version of Bosch directory, you can enable this feature. It will be exposed also locally on the port 8222 on the direct VM. And here, the metrics are very helpful with the Bosch DNS. So we experienced, when we introduced Bosch DNS to our production, we experienced issues with Bosch DNS because Bosch DNS puts quite a huge load on the message bus. And to analyze issues, those metrics could be very useful. For example, but you can experience, use them also for other issues if you have. Okay, let's talk about another sources of monitoring information. We use also logs to monitor the Bosch directory. For example, the Nginx again has an access log, the Nginx access log. We are parsing the access log and we generate information about the latency of the request, about how much traffic our Bosch directory gets and how many errors we have by all the requests. So the same you can most probably also have with the Nginx metrics. At the point when we implemented our monitoring, the Nginx metric feature wasn't available on Bosch. We introduced it later. That's why our current implementation is based on logs to have dashboards for requests. But in the future, we are planning to move to the metrics. For example, this is a dashboard which we generate of the Nginx access logs, the total incoming request over time by request status. And here you can see how many failing requests you have, how many are successful, how many you get at all, and so on. It's very useful. The same you can have for the blob store. Because it's also an Nginx, you can have the same dashboards here to analyze what's going on with your blob store. Okay, also these are the sources of monitoring information we use to monitor the Bosch directory. Let's have a look how our monitoring and logging stacks looks like. So we use the health monitor to forward the agent metrics to our monitoring system. The health monitor has some kind of plugin mechanism, so you can configure those plugins to forward the metrics to your monitoring endpoint. There are plugins for Datadog, for example, for PagerDuty. We use the Graphite plugin, so the health monitor is forwarding the metrics via the Graphite plugin in our case. For Nginx and NUTS, we do not collect the metrics at the moment, but we have this in our backlog. The plan here is to use Telegraph and forward them from the directory VM to our monitoring system. For processing, we use Riemann, and also we use Riemann to generate alerts based on those metrics. And then they are stored in InfluxDB, and we use Grafana to create dashboards and visualize the metrics. The logging stack, here we use Syswog release to forward the logs. With Syswog release, you can forward all the job logs from the directory VM or from any VM where you use the Syswog, and also the logs which are logged to Syswog. And we are forwarding them to Logstash, where the processing happens. Also, we have the option to generate alerts based on logs. In our case, we don't do not generate any alerts, but we use here Elastalert. Kibana we use to create dashboards and to visualize the logs. So let's have a look how what kind of alerts we have. So we have only one alert which requires immediate reaction, and this is directory. The inner directory is unresponsive. To trigger this alert, we have a monitoring agent on the Bosch directory itself. This is something which we implemented, and the monitoring agent queries the monitor to get the status of all the processes which monitors. And also exercises some of the directory endpoints. And from this information, the monitoring agent generates a report and sends it to our monitoring stack. And if it's if it stays unresponsive, then we will trigger a page alert. If you have a setup like this, you can also react on directory updates. And for example, when you update your directory, at the moment directory is down, and you maybe don't want to have page alerts because directory is getting updated at the moment. And with this, you can. With this setup, you can react on these cases when the monitoring agent is turning down. On the drain script, you can generate a maintenance alert and put the directory in maintenance. And then when it's getting up, you can again turn it back again to avoid false positive alerts. We have also alerts. Dashboard alerts. The dashboard alerts do not require immediate reaction. You have time to react on the next day. For example, we have one for persistent disk usage over 80%. We found this is a good threshold, and you have enough time afterwards to react on this alert. For ephemeral disk, we have 60%. You need a little bit more free space here, because during an update, the ephemeral disk is heavily used by the blob store Nginx. That's why we have a lower threshold here. We also experiment with HTTP-based alerts, but we don't have a recommendation at the moment. But they are a very valuable source for alerts also. At the end, for recap, if you care about your productive systems, you should monitor your BOSH, because if BOSH is well, this can help also your productive system. And the lesson which we learned, you should keep your monitoring very simple as possible. You have to understand what are the requirements on your BOSH directory and implement the right monitoring for you. Because if it's too complicated, people will not use the monitoring. And be careful with alerts. If you have too many type of alerts, they will get also very fast ignored by people. Yeah. Do you have any questions?
All right, if there are no questions from you guys, it's again me asking stupid questions. So you showed little snippets of dashboards. Does that mean like I just have APIs and I gotta build those dashboards myself? Or is there any plan on like providing some of that goodness to other people as well?
Maybe in the future we can improve the observability of BOSH, but at the moment there is, I don't know of any plans to provide them to people. At the moment, this is all you can we have to monitor the BOSH directory. Yeah.
So what were some of the primary causes of the alerts and the issues that you had with BOSH? So you've got all the alerting setups. So what are some of the primary issues that you had? What were the causes of those issues?
So the question was, what kind of issues we have to generate to create the alerts or to create the dashboards. We had different kind of issues actually. First, our landscape are huge. Maybe we have one of the biggest landscape operated by BOSH. And what we experienced, our BOSH users experienced many failing requests, for example. They explained, well, I'm trying to deploy something and I get bad gateway, 502. And this is why we introduced the monitoring based on HTTP access logs, Nginx HTTP access logs, to understand where, how many requests we get and where, actually try to understand where the error happens. Is it on the Nginx or is it on the direct web or is it the database? Yeah, you need then different tools, but for the first understanding, yeah, it was very helpful. We had also issues with BOSH DNS. The NATS messaging bus couldn't handle the load which BOSH DNS produced, and that's why we introduced the feature with the NATS metrics, for example. Usually, when you, first repeat the question. The question was, can you evaluate a little bit more on the BOSH DNS issues? BOSH DNS will send many NATS messages when you execute an update. And the updating itself also needs the message bus. When you update a VM, the directory is still waiting on heartbeats from the agent, for example. execute some, sends an action to the agent and waits a response from the agent also based on the message path. And when the Bosch DNS puts so much load on the message path, then the messages get timeouts, so they will timeout, and this will cause your deploy to fail, for example. Okay, we don't have any other questions. And thank you. If you want to reach me, this is my Twitter handle. Thanks for coming.